Hey guys, what's going on? This is Mina. I'm a brand new real estate investor. 2020 was my first year in real estate investing, and I managed to amass 80 plus units. Well, how did I do that? Easy. Burr. And I understand. The first thing that's gonna pop in your head,
it's impossible. My market, the numbers.
Okay, let's just take it step by step. This is my Maxwell Street property. I bought this in March 2020. Let's talk about it a little bit. Shit, there's drugs, alcohol, the roof is destroyed, there's gang signs, I got threatened by gangs. Oh Jesus, look at this. The boiler is destroyed, electrical is garbage. And it's like, so easy, I'll teach you everything, follow me, I'll show you.
Who does he think he is? Nobody's gonna buy this property. Nobody's gonna make money off this property. It is impossible. The numbers don't work. This idiot is coming all the way from Toronto. He lives 3.5 hours away. Who does he think he is to do this?
Are you not entertained? Are you not entertained?
So what is a perfect burr? What do they mean when they say that? You bought a property, you added value through renovations, you increased the value of the property, you rented it out, and then you went to the bank. The bank then, if you did your job properly, would then go look at your property, look at the rents, look at the renovations you made, and then say, okay, well, you did a good job, sir. Here, now the value of the property is this much. So that's called forced appreciation. And then when all said and done, you get that new mortgage, you pay out the first purchase, you pay out your renovations, and basically you have the property with $0 of your own money inside. And basically you have the property for free, and you have equity built into the property, and you have cash flow. Now let's look at the board. So what does that again look like? So you got a property for free, you get cash flow, because just don't get me wrong, the bank will not just give you money, here, money. No, like they have to look at the income, and the income has to cover all the expenses, all the mortgage, and it has to have extra cash flow. So you have the extra cash flow, and you have zero money in, so that's no money left, and you have, potentially you get appreciation as well. We don't bank on that, but in a lot of cases, you might get some appreciation. You get mortgage pay down. This is also an underrated benefit to real estate, because while you're sitting and you're renting it out, every month you pay that mortgage, some of it is interest, some of it is principal, which also is a gain to you. So you have free built-in equity, which is kind of underrated as well, because if the property is valued at $100, the bank usually gives you 80% of that only. So there's another 20. Where does that go? That's yours. You own that goddamn 20 bucks. Well, you got out all that money out. What do you do now? You could go buy Ferraris if you want, or you could repeat that thing and exponentially increase your wealth over time. So that is why burr is great. Now let's dive into how I did it with this property on Maxwell Street. Boom. Okay, so this property was on the market for quite a while. Nobody wanted to buy it. Why? It was a nightmare, okay? There was drugs, there were massive issues with it. Roof is garbage, boiler, electrical, everything that you can think of. I just don't know any terminology, unfortunately. The rents were very low and the tenants were kind of horrible. So I got this property as a wholesale deal from Matt McKeever. The property was for $305,000. It was a sixplex, so basically has six self-contained units. We had closing costs and fees because I bought it from someone, so I had to pay him a fee, and that was $15,000. And then the current rents at the time, this is March 2020 when I bought it, was $2,500 roughly. So bear in mind, I have a full-time job. I work as a pharmacist in Toronto, and this property is in Sarnia, so it's around 3.5 hours away. Was it hard managing a project, you know, 3.5 hours away? Oh my God, yes. Were there issues? There was a whole, but all the issues. There were all the issues that you can think of. The roof, garbage, people working there. Some people stole from me. Other people didn't do their job. I got promises that were undelivered. I got drug dealing. I got gang signs. I got threatened. Like everything, okay? Was it a risk? Absolutely it was a risk. But it was a risk I was willing to take because I wanted to learn real estate. I wanted to know how people do this, and I was willing to take on this project. And in my mind, if I lost, that was cool, but I gained a very valuable lesson that I'll always use. So let's fast forward to January 2021 and see what happened after all this work back and forth. I had to pay rentals and holding costs and a bunch of other miscellaneous expenses, which was around $120,000. So the old tenants left, we put in new tenants, and now the new rents are $7,500. So we increased them for $2,500 all the way to $7,500. Was it easy? No. Was it really hard? Eh, kind of. But did I learn? I learned a whole bunch of things about how to manage a project in general, what can I expect, and what to do when people steal from you. Okay, cool, now to the sexy part, the refinance. So what does refinance mean again, real quick? It means the bank goes, looks at your property, looks at what you've done, looks at the rents, and then they kind of determine what's the value of the property now. How do they determine that? Two things, comps, which means comparables. Number two, income. So they look at other properties similar to yours, what are they selling for, and what is the income and what can it support? In my case, this property that I just bought for $305,000, and I put $120,000, is now appraised for, wait for it.
Wait for it. Here it comes. Almost there.
$1 million. I was baffled. Like, $1 million? Are you guys crazy? I can stand here and tell you, like, I'm this genius. I knew it all along. It was just my hard work and my determination. I'm just the, but I could say all that. And yes, obviously I worked harder than the average individual. Obviously I had a full-time job and I had to drive back and forth. I had to put up with the stress with the people stealing from me. And I also had other projects on the go. This was not my only one. However, a lot of the credit actually goes to the person I bought the deal from because it was a great deal from the first place. First of all, it was cheap as shit. Number two, this property didn't cost me any mortgage at all. It had something called a vendor take-back mortgage at 0% interest. Again, like I didn't mention that in the beginning, but I paid $0 throughout that year. Like I held the property, paid $0 mortgage. It was a greatly negotiated deal in the first place. Number two, there was a bunch of appreciation going on. I got that as well. You can't always expect that. I was lucky enough to get it. Number three, yes, I had a bunch of people steal from me. However, I also had a lot of people like really help me with this project. I bought the deal from Matt McKeever. He sold it to me for $10,000. This deal made me a shit ton of money, as you can see. I had Old South Roofing, Mike Van Hout. The roof was completely destroyed, according to everybody else, and they wanted to charge me around 25 to 30 grand at least to fix it. This guy comes in and he charged me 13. I met other investors, including my now partner Jamie in other projects, who helped me tremendously on this deal. Cutting costs, managing contractors, getting beautiful rents. So I definitely could have not have done this alone. Okay, let's move on with the numbers. $1 million, what does that mean? Do I get $1 million check? No, wait. As we said, the bank only gives you a portion of that. In my case, the bank gave me $750,000. That's the right thing here. Okay, let's recap real quick. What is the new value of the building? It's $1 million. Here's the appraisal just for you naysayers out there. Okay, I understand it says 993,000, but $1 million is a much sexier number. Just these are cool. So new value, $1 million. What is the equity owned? Remember, the bank gave me only 75%, so I own now equity for $250,000. I did it with all green shit, so that means it's positive. The cash I paid back, so I had borrowed the down payment to purchase this property. I had also borrowed the money to do the renovations. So I had to pay back that money, it's not mine. So I paid back $440,000, which is $120,000, and the purchase price of the property and all the holding costs and all that. So all that went to the appropriate parties. So what does that leave me with? All you math nerds, it leaves me with $310,000.
Cool, Mina, where do these go, the $310,000?
Well, that's surplus, that's all for me.
Wait, what does that mean? What does that mean, all for you?
Well, let me explain it again, please, just, can you press that goddamn, you're here already. Like you already spent like most of the video. You could leave me a like, you could subscribe, it would be fantastic. I want YouTube to think I'm the shit. If you don't think so, well, let YouTube think so. It's $310,000 in cash, $250,000 of extra equity owned in the property. So now my total earned is $560,000. Is it that easy? Wait, aren't you forgetting something?
Well, Mina, you have a new mortgage now. Like, you have a lot of debt, you have a lot of...
Yes, I understand. I'm getting to it if you give me a second. Yes, there is a lot of debt, because now The bank came in and put a mortgage on the property for $750,000, which is why I only have $250,000 in. Now let's look at these numbers for you skeptical folk out there, rightfully so. Always be skeptical, always ask questions. New mortgage. So now, my current rents, as mentioned, are $7,500. Okay, let's slow down here. How do you calculate cash flow on a general scheme of things? Cash flow is calculated as rents minus every single expense minus the mortgage. That brings you cash flow. So $7,500 minus $300 a month in property tax, $250 in insurance, $200 in water, $260 in gas, $50 in hydro, remember meters are separate, $370, which is 5% as maintenance, we keep it on the side, and I also add 6% in property management, which is $450, because I live 3.5 hours away. I can't do everything myself. So what does that look like? $7,500 minus all that crap gives you $5,620. Beautiful. So does that mean I get $5,620 every month? No, there's the mortgage. You were just asking me that. Oh God. $7,500 minus all the expenses, $5,620. The mortgage on the property is $750,000. I got a great deal. My mortgage is $3,220 a month. So what is my net cash flow right now? $5,620, which is after all expenses, you remove the mortgage of $3,220, then you get $2,400 a month. So yes, you have extra debt on the property. However, you have enough rents to cover all that, to cover all the expenses, to cover the mortgage, to put aside a portion for maintenance, and still have cash flow. I also, on my end, after all these expenses, I also add another 10% as a safety net for myself. I put it for, you know, bad debt, tenants don't pay a certain month, CapEx for later, even though I just did brand new renovations, a lot of things. So that other 10% is $750. So for me, I keep all these safety nets just for my own safety, and my net cash flow is now $1,650. So every month I get $1,650 from this property. Let me be very clear, owning real estate is extremely powerful. You get cash flow, appreciation, you can do forced appreciation, you get tax benefits. So what did I do with this money? Well, I took this money and I'm going to continue reinvesting in real estate. A lot of people will say, well, you're just onboarding debt. I am onboarding debt. However, this is not an iPhone. This is not a car. This is an appreciating asset which spits out income every month on top of the cost of the debt. So this is what people call good debt.
Well, what if like a crash happens? What if like a...
There's a lot of what ifs. So what is the moral of the story here? Should you just buy all the properties because they all go up? No. You need to learn the fundamentals. You need to move. However, you need to move quick. And you also need to sometimes shut out the noise. A lot of people will tell you,
well, man, you don't know anything. You need to wait like 7 years just to understand. Like,
it's not that complicated. It is simple. You 1000% can do it. And you need to just take an extra step towards that direction. So if you want to take extra time, great. Move at your own pace. However, move in that direction. So if you're watching this video and you reached this far, it means you're probably very interested in doing this thing. And the moral of the story here is do not listen to every idiot who tells you something. Just try it today. Go to someone, just tell them, well, man, I was thinking of doing X, just whatever X is. Automatically, you'll find, well, here are the thousands of problems that could happen. You need to put yourself in the mindset of, I solve problems. Myself, zero experience in real estate. Zero, I still don't know anything, and I don't think I'll know much. However, what I know about myself is that if there's a problem that arises, I will figure it out, I will learn whatever I have to, and I'll solve it immediately. Because every problem is an opportunity to make some cash. Because as cliche as this sounds, every problem is an opportunity in disguise. In this case, I did go through a whole bunch of problems. It was a headache, it was a nightmare for months on end. However, what's the payout? I got $550,000 worth of value, and I have a property for free, and I get cash flow, and I can leverage it into more. You don't have to leverage, you don't have to over-leverage, you don't have to do any of that. For me, I'm in growth mode right now. My goal for this year is to buy at least 100 more apartments. You don't have to do that. You can only buy a duplex a year. Do whatever works for you. However, Don't let other ideas influence you and change your mind into doing something that someone else wants to do. Anyways, that's enough for this ramble. I'm gonna assume you didn't like or comment or subscribe, so this is pointless to say this. Thanks very much for watching. I have another video, like for my first property ever, which was, we'll put it right here. If you wanna watch that, that's fantastic. If not, thank you very much, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace!